Hey, hello Abibi here. In this video, I'm going to add aiming mode to this character. Right now, I have a gun on my hand, and if I click this attack button, the character is attacking by using his hand and his foot to kick and punch. While I have gun here, I want to use my gun. So right now, in this video, I'm going to add this new animation or motion from Mixamo. I've downloaded this motion. It is called Pistol Idle, I think. Yeah, Pistol Idle. I'm going to add this pose to the character. So when I click this attack button while I'm in this gun mode, it should not attack using hand and foot like this. Instead, I'm going to switch the pose of the character to this gun aiming mode, and then for the firing gun, that will be require that will consume some times. It will require some times to me to do the tutorial, so I will do that one on the next video. In this video, I will add this motion. So here I'm going to modify the attack button ability functionality here. Here is my attack. This one is my attack button, and it is calling my player.attack in this script. This is the script. Edit the script. Where is the attack? Here it is, attack. Well, because this attack function was made when I was only has punch, I had no gun, so today I need to modify it. Here I am going to add an if statement. I will only this use attack code here only if I have weapon with code 0 on my character, on my player. If current, hang on, I forgot what is the variable. Okay, this is game data dot current weapon. If game data dot current weapon is 0, which is punch, I will do this attack mode. Integer and attack mode, okay, and paste it here inside this if block. Else, here I will do the else statement. If game data dot current weapon equals to 1, which is the gun that I have now, here I will code the gun aiming pose. So I have the gun aiming pose, and I will add it to my animation controller, which is here inside my here inside this folder. Let me open it, and here I will add a new state. I call it gun idle, and the motion I set it to which one is pistol idle. Yeah, pistol idle. And then I create parameter pull is aiming, is gun aiming. I add a transition like this, and as usual is gun aiming false for this one, and this one is gaming is gun aiming through without exit time. Then in my script here I will call this setbool car animator dot setbool, which one is that? Yeah, this one. Paste it here and I change it to is gun aiming, is gun aiming. I set the value to true. Okay, let me check the game. I need to run it, click play button. I want to attack by punching or kicking, and then I switch my weapon to this pistol or gun. Then I click this button. It is aiming like this. The character is aiming the gun like this. I know it's not perfect the motion, but whatever, this is just a demonstration. Maybe I can change the so what I'm planning is I'm going to use this pistol aiming pose as a fake thing, because I'm going to switch between this third person to first person mode. If I click this attack button when I have a gun, I want to switch to first person mode to fire a gun, because firing a gun with third person mode is somehow difficult for me to do it, because it has so it needs some animation. For example, if you aim the gun upward, we should animate this character to aim upward. And if I switch my camera angle like this, the hand of the character should be bent over there that way, so we can have the fire the character that is aiming to any direction, and that is difficult to me to do it. So for the simplicity, I'm going to use FPS mode or first person mode for gun aiming or for gun firing. Alright, so let me continue this attack button. If I click this attack button again, it should go out of this gun idle pose. So I will add a new variable here for my character. Here on my public boolean variable, I'm going to add is gun aiming. By default, the value is false, and here inside attack function, I will add another if statement. If not true, the value of is gun aiming, then I call this is gun aiming to true. Else I will do the opposite, set bool is gun aiming to false. Let me check again. Let me stop and rerun the game. Okay, I'm going to aim my gun, and then I click again to go out of this mode. Okay, it's not working. Let's check. Okay, I did not assign a value to the gun aiming here, so that's why it didn't work. I add this bracket. Then here I set its gun aiming to true, and I do the opposite here on else statement. Here I set the value to false. Okay, let's try it again. Aiming and what? Alright, this is not correct. If statement block, the else should be inside this inside this block. So I will move it here and this is why I hate Visual Studio, because it is automatically type something that I don't want to. It caused this problem, maybe because I'm not used to using it. So okay, this must be correct. If it's not gain, if the value of is gun aiming false, I call this block of code, and else I call this one. Let me go back and play the game. Aiming and this aiming, I don't know, not aiming, aiming, not aiming, and I can walk again. Alright, that is for aiming, gun aiming pose. What I'm going to do next is to switch between this third person mode to first person mode when I am in this game gun aiming mode. Okay, that's all for this video, and for the switch between first person and third person, I will do it on my next video. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.